So hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and today I'm here with the Wolf Among Us. I almost said The Sims 3, but anyways, yes, we are back with the Wolf Among Us. And if you, oh my god, last episode was so intense. Like, it's been the most intense. Like, I don't know if you agree with me, but so far I just couldn't believe my mind. And there was a lot of censoring I had to do, and I know I did a horrible job, and I know I missed some here and there, but there was nothing I could do because there were so many. And yeah, I tried my best, I really did, but I know I missed some here and there, so sorry about that. We met, I forgot what her name was. It started with an N. Narcia? Or something like that. And she was the Little Mermaid. And yeah, she was like pole dancing naked for Georgie, the owner of the nightclub. And then we find out that, well, we. Okay, let me rephrase this. So all our evidences are leading toward Crane. We saw his picture. He was, touching Lily. And yeah, and there was like a pool of blood where he and Lily had laid. And at the very end, we also saw Crane looking through the magic mirror and breaking it because he saw us. He saw Bigby and Beauty, finding out about his picture and all his little fetishes and things like that. So that was what happened last part. And if you guys see right here, it's I have to restart the episode because I was filming it and then my brother came home, and none of my family knows, none of my friends know that I do YouTube. And so it was kind of a like a uh-oh moment, I guess, for me. So yeah, I started the game, but then my brother came in the middle, so yeah, I have to start restart the episode. But enough blabbering. Wait. Yeah, this one. So enough blabbering, and we'll just get started.
Our stories used to be so simple. We had a beginning, a middle, and an end. But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused.
I can't tell you anything.
You can't or you won't.
Snow. I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once, and...
I'm not yours to lose. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
She looks like Holly.
It's not Holly, it's her sister Lily.
She was hooking to pay down debt. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the pudding and pie.
My name is Nerissa.
Well, Nerissa, I've got some questions. The open arms.
Oh my god! What is it?
It's Crane. That motherfucking piece of shit!
Crane? Ugh, God, you think you know a person. Bigby, you have to tell her.
I know!
What's going on? What did you find up there? You know, other than the...
Crane's the killer!
What? Ichabod Crane? How do you know?
Shit!
Crane's been... Oh, Bigby, calm down. Everything's going to be fine. okay? It's going to be fine.
Crane might be following Snow. If I can find her, I can... God damn it!
Okay, it's going to be okay. Where did you see her last? Did she say where she was going?
She took Holly to the business office to prepare for the funeral.
Lily's funeral?
Yeah.
How do you know?
I was just at the Trip Trap, and I heard Gren telling some folks about a funeral at the Buckingham Bridge.
The Trip Trap? Are you drinking?
When?
Right now. They were on their way out.
Bigby! Wait.
What?
Snow's been through a lot. There are things she doesn't talk about. Just please be careful when you tell her. And you should tell her. But...
Beauty, I have to go.
Just wait a second and listen. This is important. You know how you felt when you saw that picture? Well, it's going to be much worse for her. Just remember that.
Okay, so this is where the funeral is being held, and this is when my brother came into my room and I had to stop recording. Okay, so we hear Snow talking.
Fables she was truly close to. If you're here, then you were part of a very special circle. People she trusted and cared for. I won't offend you by claiming one day that the pain of losing Lily will ever subside.
I'm sorry, Snow, but this is important. I have something to tell you.
Really, Bigby? It's so important it can't wait 15 minutes until it's maybe not at the worst possible time? I'm sorry, everyone. I don't...
Get the fuck out of here.
Holly, wait.
He has no right to be here. Not after what he did.
Look, Holly, I'm not here to start trouble.
You throw my sister down the witching well, and you have the nerve to show your face here. After you lie? After you promise me?
Holly, wait. That was Crane. Just Crane. He disposed of Lily's body before Bigby could do anything about it. I'm telling you the truth.
Don't cover for him.
But this genuinely wasn't his fault.
You can't tell me Bigby gives a shit about this.
I'm sorry, Holly. I didn't know he put her down the witching well.
Bigby cares, Holly. He's trying to help, and I'm sure he has a very good reason for being here. But this
one
isn't on him.
Why are you here anyway? And don't say it's because you care about this.
Everything okay?
I'm here to talk to Snow.
Oh, really?
Yes, Holly. This is serious.
Okay, look. Bigby and I are going to have a little chat far away from the ceremony, all right? Look, Holly, I know how this must...
No, you don't know how this must feel. You have no idea. Don't fuck anything up. Don't bother anybody. And when the first sign of trouble comes, and it will come because you're a goddamn walking trap for it, I want you the fuck out of here. You hear me?
I just want to get Lily's killer, Holly. Nothing more.
Let's just continue, okay?
This is such total fucking bullshit.
Let's go, Holly.
It's your turn to talk.
This better be wildly important.
It is very important.
It's hard enough making a connection with these people. When you pull this kind of stuff, it just resets the clock.
Snow, Crane is completely obsessed with you.
Oh my god, if this is about how Crane treats me at work...
Just listen to me for a second, all right? I followed a lead to this shithole motel, the Open Arms. Crane had a room there, and he's been taking prostitutes, or at the very least Lily, and making her look like you while he was, you know. He replays your story over and over again.
This is... I don't even know what to say right now. I really don't. I'm just trying everything I can right now to not picture it.
I'm sorry, Snow. And I'm sorry I had to be the one to tell you.
You're sure this is what happened? This is what he's been doing?
Because, picture!
Please, Bigby, don't confuse things.
Picture. A picture is worth a thousand words.
You took a cab here, right?
Yeah.
I'll drive. Snow? Narissa? What is it?
I'm sorry, but Holly's asking for you.
Are they starting the burn?
Yes. Everyone who spoke should really be present for this part. She's kind of distraught. You're not leaving yet, are you?
2 minutes. I don't mean to be,
No, I understand.
It's just that something's come up.
No, I get it. Take your time.
It won't take long.
How'd it go? At the motel?
Bad, bad, very bad.
No?
It was Crane's room. But you knew that already, right?
Narissa!
Yeah, coming!
Constable? wait, easy now, girl.
Oh my god.
Goes, the first thing in a visit, you say, how do you do? How do you do?
What are you doing here?
That is the question, isn't it? Or at least a question. We'll snip to the chase for all sakes. A little bird told us that you're fitting to go after Crane. And you see, we have an interest in that particular boy. So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone. Just take a vacation is all.
Are you working for Crane? Did he send you?
No, see now, you're already asking too many questions. Just pay attention. So what's it gonna be? We have a deal? You leave Crane alone, and we leave you to yours? Brother, speak your mind. Fastly now.
You think this act you got going scares me? Cause it doesn't.
Always wanting to do things the fun way.
I hope.
Ladies, gentlemen, invertebrates, please, rest easy. This is not.
What the hell is going on?
What's happening?
Very sorry to impose, but we only had a deal to work out with Bigby. And we're unhappy to report that things did not go as smoothly as planned.
Bigby, what is he talking about?
Never you mind that. It ain't any of your...
What deal? They want me to leave Crane alone.
Crane?
Oh, now you shouldn't have done that, old boy. Really. That wasn't right, telling everyone our dealings.
I'm not part of your deal. What? Oh my God.
What did I tell you? What did I say?
Holly?
You think you motherfuckers can come here uninvited? You think you can just fucking interrupt Lily's funeral?
Calm down, darling. It's just a simple business transaction.
You fucking freaks are not getting away with this.
Holly, don't move.
Calm down, Holly.
Yeah, let's spare all the fuss. It's just a dead whore.
Oh my god, don't. Please don't. Don't.
I got it done.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Q. Oh. No. Oh my god, is it my fault? No. Please tell me that's not my fault. Oh, I'm gonna feel so bad. Okay, but what about the other guy? Is he dead? Oh my gosh. Okay, so it's episode 3, A Crooked Mile. Who is this dude?
I did as well as I could to take out the buckshot, but there's still some shards left embedded in your shoulder. They'll eventually worm their way out on their own, but until they do, you're going to be sore.
Bigby, Dr. Swinehart was appointed Fabletown physician for a reason.
It's okay. There's only one thing you have to take away from all this. Take it easy.
Ah,
don't
that
go
noise.
Looking for any more fights. Keep strain off your heart.
How's everyone else? They all make it?
They're fine.
Even Holly?
Everyone that got
Lily?
Home. Holly refused to let me see where she lived. So I left her and Grendel back at her bar with a dose of juniper and spring water. They're titans, Bigby. They'll be fine. Just remember what I said. The stitches won't hold up if you continue to act like you normally do. Everything in moderation. And eat more chicken.
I'll try to.
Eat more chicken.
Right then. Very good.
What?
Business office. I know. I'll have to call you back. The town is starting to find out.
Well, I'll leave you two to it then. Miss White, Bigby.
So, to recap.
Crane watched me through the magic mirror uncover his room at the Open Arms, and then he smashed it so we couldn't use it ourselves to go after. And we know this because Bufkin was drinking in the rafters. That about cover it?
And once he puts all the pieces back together, it'll be easy to catch Crane. So, I guess that's the plan, currently. But I don't know.
There's no other leads. This is it. Just wait for the mirror.
Yeah. What the hell is going on? Just, I don't know what the Tweedles get out of this. I don't know if Crane sent them. I don't know if... I mean, this is gonna sound crazy, but do you really think Crane did it? Everything points to him. I get it. But do you really think he killed those women?
From what I saw at the Open Arms, everything points to Crane murdering Lily. What isn't adding up for me is Faith. Why would he kill her? It doesn't seem connected.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense. He was a conniver, a coward, a liar. And I'll always hate him for that. And I'll hate him for how he held me in his thoughts. But murdering prostitutes? Ow! Everything okay over there?
Oh, no.
Yes, Miss White. I just cut myself on a piece of the glass. Nothing to worry about.
Get him a band-aid or something.
Thanks for tonight, by the way. That could have gone really terribly. I mean, even worse than it did.
I just can't fucking stand that they got away.
We'll catch up to them, Bigby. You did enough. Can I, ask you a question? It's kind of personal. And I don't want to offend you.
Why? What's on your mind?
It's just... when stuff hits the fan, like it did tonight, it feels like before we came to the city. It feels kind of like home. And I've heard it said that maybe in some tiny little bottled-up way, deep inside, you kind of enjoy it when things go wrong. Because it gives you an excuse to just, you know, stop pretending.
Fuck no, I don't enjoy it. Are you kidding me? It's horrible what happened tonight. I wish it didn't happen.
I shouldn't have said anything. Forget that I did.
We already said everything.
We have a problem.
What is it?
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing a piece.
Oh, damn it.
What do you mean, missing a piece?
Yes, it's,
Crane must have taken a shard with him.
Oh, I can't believe this.
I saw Crane pick something up after he smashed it. I'm sorry, I didn't realize what it was until now.
It's not your fault.
The mirror can't work unless it's whole.
Well, that's not entirely true.
Or what, Bufkin? What? We sit around and wait until it mends itself? We have no idea how long that will take. We're just gonna have to do this the hard way.
I'm just saying, waiting is an option.
No.
What exactly is the hard way?
We'll look through his things, his desk, everything. He had to have left something that tells us where he's going. He's a neat freak, but he was never that smart.
Oh, that's nice.
Take a piece of the mirror. We can still solve this ourselves. I know.
Never mind that. Come help me look.
Why are you so mean to him? Oh, he was just trying to help. Oh, and another thing, I'm currently eating ice cream right now, so if you guys hear anything, I'm really sorry. I'll try to eat it as far away from the mic as I can. So we'll first talk to him.
Hi, Mr. Bigby. I can still help you catch Crane, you know.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. I saw him jump on the telephone before he left. He called up somebody. He said he needed to see his witch, or that he would need to get to the witch for that, whoever that is.
His witch?
Yes, it sounded like the one he got his snow glamours from.
Hmm.
It's definitely not your fault.
You didn't see anything else, did you?
No, not especially.
What do you mean, not especially?
Why didn't you try and stop him?
What do you want me to do, yank on his hair? I'm only 3 feet tall. There are limits here.
Okay.
That is true.
Look, the whole mirror thing, it's not your fault, right?
You mean it?
Yeah.
I'll just see if I can do anything about this.
You do that.
It's not your fault. You are drunk. You had no idea what Crane was doing, so... I'm definitely not going to blame Bufkin for anything. Because I honestly feel like it's not his fault. And I think the only thing we could do is talk to Snow and look at his desk. We'll look at his desk first. Where are you going? Oh. Okay, so we have an inbox right here. 207.
What is it?
It's the key to his room at the Open Arms.
You still haven't told me what was in there.
Oh, you do not want to know.
I want to know. I need to know.
Crane was, paying Lily to live out a fantasy of him and you together. Forgive me if I spare you the details.
I keep thinking back. I keep replaying moments in my head. Interactions with him when he'd catch me in the elevator or bump into me outside. There's only so much you can repress, you know?
What else is there?
Come on, let's keep looking.
Maybe I should have just told her about, like, the flower in bed. Are there any updates on the extra funding I requested? As I explained in my last letter, the conditions here could do with some improvement. I'm seeing some unrest from the residents, and I have to admit I can see why. The farm should not be a punishment. I'm sure you're busy, but I think this should be a priority. Best, Wayland Smith. So something about the farm. I'm guessing they're all from the farm. Maybe not. Okay, so I'm writing to ask again that you please send someone to fix the air conditioning in our unit. It's burning up in the apartment, and Pinocchio says his skin is splintering. I don't know what that means, but I assume it's something gross, and I really like it if you fix the air like you like we asked you 3 months ago, and the very least, provide us a fan in the meantime. Sincerely, Boy Blue. Last one. You said you paid to have the plaster redone in my building after the last incident in 204. It's falling off the walls. Please fix it. I can't rent out that room as it is, and I've already been waiting 4 days. Not to mention you already promised me you'd send someone to fix the big crack in the glass on the front door. Well, guess what? It's worse now. Get it together.
Did Crane ever do any work?
Only when Cole was around.
Who's Cole? Okay, and I think Snow is the last
one. Buffkin says that he overheard Crane call somebody before he left. Sounds like he's going to see a witch, or his witch. His glamour witch.
Wait, really? None of the 13th floor witches would allow that sort of thing. They must be somewhere in the city. It's something, at least.
Find anything?
No, but there's enough notes and stuff here to take all night. Keep looking.
Okay, never mind. But we already examined his desk. Oh, we forgot to open the drawer. Force it open. Oh. Okay, so we'll examine the books. The Office of Business Affairs.
There's a page here that was torn out.
Oh, yeah? Buffkin, do you know what was here?
It's a ring, at least. Every magical item not retained in the armory is assigned to someone in Fable Town. It must be this witch he is going to see.
Yeah, I only recently heard about this meeting. Why didn't you mention this before?
No one asked me.
Buffkin!
And I'm hungover. I'm sorry.
Oh, poor Buffkin.
We set the meeting at 2 a.m. tonight.
What's going on?
Oh my
God. Is
the
mirror fixed yet?
Bluebeard, this isn't the time.
Is the mirror fixed or isn't it? You called me.
I called just to see if you knew where Crane could be, and that was it, okay? And I'm sorry I said anything more than that.
What did you say?
Well, you did, and I know. The cat's out of the bag. So, can we find the dull pervert or not?
I don't know why Snow told you anything.
He and Crane talk all the time, okay? He was a resource, albeit one that turned out to be useless.
We hardly talk all the time. Besides, why spend time on such gutter snipe?
Look, this just isn't the time. He took a piece of the mirror, so we can't use it.
The only thing we know is that Crane's going to see a witch at 2 o'clock.
Buffkin, don't say that aloud.
A.M.
Listen, Bluebeard, you're not a part of this.
I don't think you're in any position to turn away help.
What do you know about Crane, anyway?
That he has the stones to kill prostitutes like any common sex-frightened serial killer and not face a real challenge.
Look, we know that Crane is going to see a witch, and it's to acquire a magic ring.
What's the ring?
We don't know what it does or who it's assigned to since Crane tore its page out of the book.
This farce was your ridiculous idea for a plan. I mean, who put you in charge in the first place?
Fixing the mirror was the most logical
thing. You're a secretary. He's the sheriff. And none of you were chosen to run this office. Who elected you to make these decisions?
Nobody, but that
doesn't... Who elected her to spend my money?
Well, I've been doing that unofficially for years.
Snow can obviously handle this, so let's drop it.
Well then. Excuse me for having the Commonwealth in mind.
Yeah, right, but you were only thinking about yourself.
All right, let's just look on the bright side. We know Crane is going to see the witch that's been supplying him black market glamours.
Thanks to me.
And that he'll be there at 2. So that gives
us... He's so cute.
A few short hours to find out who it is and where they live and get them all at once.
And a few shorter hours, the more you babble about it.
We haven't been the ones babbling.
Yeah, yeah. Just point in the direction you want me to check first.
Since Lily used the glamours, she'd have known who the witch was. And I don't think Holly's burned her things yet. It would probably have the address or a phone number or something.
And Bigby is free to go there if he likes. But I think the question you should be asking is just what do the two Tweedles know about this?
It doesn't matter what they know. After tonight, they'd never go to their office.
They're not smart enough to try and go anywhere else.
The Trip Trap is the better option to track the witch down. That has to be our focus.
Look, chances are I'll have to swing by both anyway, so...
No, chances are you won't have time.
I don't really care what you two do. I'm going to his apartment.
What? You can't just go up there.
And why the hell not?
We already looked for the key, remember? I don't know where it is.
Then I'll pick the blasted lock! I've wasted enough time waiting for the mirror to find him. I won't waste any more.
You just can't go up there alone, all right?
I've no interest in nicking his drapes, my dear, if that's what concerns you.
What concerns me is you traipsing through possible evidence.
Oh, now it's evidence.
Bluebeard, just stay out of it, all right? You'll just mess things up further.
They can't get any more messed up.
We have to find the witch, Bluebeard, since that's where he's going.
Or the sniveling weasel chickened out. Never went anywhere. And is upstairs right now in his pitiful penthouse, crafting a fort out of couch cushions. Look, this is how a smart person would do it. So this is how we're going to do it. Wherever you go, I'll go to the other.
I don't like you going anywhere unsupervised. He's up to something. I don't know what it is, but we don't have the time to really worry about it now. Where are you gonna go, Bigby?
So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy and I don't need charity.
So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone.
Dee and Dumb must know where he is. I should go to their office first.
Perfect. And I'll go to Crane's apartment.
I'll look up their address. I hope you know what you're doing.
Excuse me.
Hi, Sheriff Bigby. Great to see you. I don't know if you remember me. I've seen you around, but you may have forgotten.
I know who you are, Flycatcher. You've worked at the Woodlands for how many years now?
I think I've lost count. But you know, Crane let me go recently.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, it's no big deal. So, what brings you here? I mean, can I help you with anything? Are you here to see one of the brothers? Dee or Dumb? They're in here right now. I'm not sure when they'll be back.
I was hoping to have a talk with Dee or Dumb. Do you know where they are?
No, they don't really keep regular hours as far as I can tell. Sorry. It's been a quiet night so far. I think the twins are out, probably working on a case. Sometimes I don't see them for days. They gave me the job after Crane told me to get lost.
Where's their office?
Oh, right this way. I was going there next anyway. I can let you in if you want. You can wait for them there.
Sure. Thanks.
No problem.
I'm gonna have to take a look around.
Well, I guess that would be okay.
I wasn't really asking for permission.
Right. You're the sheriff. I just don't want to get in trouble or anything. I'm sure it's fine. I mean, they never told me not to let you in.
Don't worry. I won't get you in trouble, all right?
Right.
Dear Brother Dumb, I hate dogs and you know it. Sincerely, Brother D. What's that about?
They do have their quirks.
Dear Brother D, I think we should get ourselves a dog. Sincerely, Brother Dar. Couple of freaks. This is pointless.
I know these guys can come off abrasive at times, but they aren't so bad once you get to know them. And they really care about helping people. They're kind of loud at times, but you get used to it.
How do you mean they help people?
They're detectives. Anyone can come in here with a problem and they'll do their best to fix it. The way Dee explains it, it's like if someone lost their cat, well, they could hire them to, you know, track it down. Or like sometimes they get packages for people. They can be like couriers, you know?
For who?
All kinds. Come to think of it, I don't really know where they keep them. Anyways, I'm just saying, you just don't know them like I do.
Sure, Flycatcher. You know about this?
No. I'm sure you have your reasons, but it's just they've done so much for me.
Let's see if they got a file on Crane. In debt to the Crooked Man? Shit. Detective Brannigan. Keep an eye on her. Ichabod Crane. He owes the Crooked Man money. Shit. How is he planning to pay this all back? Request for property acquisition. Further details filed under Donkey Skin. Crane hired them to look for a photo? Why did he want it back so badly? So that's why they were at her apartment, and the woodsman's place.
See, I knew you wouldn't find anything. Anything of interest, anyways. They're detectives, like I said.
Just stay out of this. I have work to do.
I'm just saying.
Look, just trust me on this. Tweedledee and Dumb are not nice. They're not helping anyone.
Well, they helped me.
Okay, great. They helped you. It's one person. Now, please, just let me concentrate here.
Find anything?
Not what I need.
What if you're wrong about them?
I'm not.
They're misunderstood, sure, but that doesn't mean everything people say about them is true. I mean, you know, like when I think about it, you guys aren't that different. You help people, and they help people. Not that it's any of my business, but...
Is that what you think?
Bigby?
Shit. There's something here. I know there is. There has to be.
Why would there be anything?
Because they're lying to you, okay, Flycatcher? That's why. They aren't detectives. They shot at Snow White.
Bigby, what happened to your...
You want to know what this is? This is them showing up to Lily's funeral with fucking shotguns.
I'm sorry. I didn't know.
Look, Flycatcher, I know you like them, but they're a part of whatever is happening here. They're bad guys. I didn't mean to...
There's a door behind this file cabinet. Now, I don't know what they keep back here, but it might be what you're looking for. Well, that key you found should work. Wow.
Hold for BCW.
What are you looking for exactly? Maybe I can help.
Anything about Crane, or the witch he was using. Something. J.D. A book. This doesn't really tell us much. Butcher. What is this stuff? Sorry, I know I'm late. I'll get it to you soon. Ichabod Crane.
Who was he sending money to?
Crooked man. Care of the Lucky Pawn. Do you know what that is?
Is that what you needed?
I don't think so, but... it's interesting. There's more going on here. I still need to find that witch, though.
Hey, Bigby. Do you think, after all this, do you think I could come back to the Woodlands? Since Crane let me go, I mean, I can still work here, but I don't think I want to now. I don't want to work with bad people, you know?
Well, Crane is gone now. I can't see why he couldn't come back to the Woodlands.
Really? That would be... thank you.
Come by the business office. I can't make any promises.
Right, of course.
It's Snow's hair.
Snow White? Why...
We found her hair like this inside Lily's glamour. Auntie Greenleaf. This must be the witch Crane was using.
I guess Dee and Dumb were getting the hair for Crane and sending it to her? That's not a pleasant thought.
There's no address on it.
So what now? Snow would probably want to know about this.
I should tell Snow about this. She might need to change her locks.
Well, I can take care of that, if you want.
Maybe she can find a record on this Auntie Greenleaf.
I think I saw a phone near the back.
Thanks.
You're welcome, Sheriff.
Business office, this is Snow White.
Hey, Snow.
Oh, it's you. Sorry, I've been answering angry phone calls for hours. People want to know where Crane is. How'd it go with the Tweedle brothers?
No address yet, but I got a name for Crane's witch, Auntie Greenleaf. You heard of her?
No. I'll get Buffkin started looking for a record, but it might take some time.
Huh. Somebody's got to know where to find her. And Snow, I found a note with some money attached. Crane has been embezzling from Fabletown.
Of course, because why half-ass being a complete sleazeball? Do you think this is tied to the murders? I mean, I guess it doesn't matter yet.
I think it's connected. Maybe the girls found out about it. I don't know.
Maybe. You might want to try Holly's place, see if she hasn't burned Lily's things yet. Or Crane's, you might find something there. Although Bluebeard's been there. I'll leave it up to you, but we don't have much time. Crane is meeting her at 2 a.m.
I'll go to the Trip Trap, see about Lily's things. I think that's our best option.
Sounds good. Just be gentle with Holly when you get there, okay? I'll give Bufkin the name and hope he finds something in the records.
Let me know what he comes up with.
I'll be in touch. I hope you'll do the same.
We'll catch him, Snow.
Bigby, I have to go. Someone just came in. Good luck. Thank you.